Hello everyone, I'm Neeraj Garg and I'm the Chief Operating Officer at Applessify. Today's session is all about how to keep your AMS healthy once you have implemented it. So it's for any association management company or associations or nonprofits who have just implemented their AMS or have implemented a long back. So you are running an AMS now and so I just want to give you some tips on how to keep your AMS healthy once it has been running and your actual users have started using the system. So, and these key points are based on our experience with different clients that we have worked with and different things that we have guided them in order to keep their AMS functioning smoothly. So when you actually start using an AMS, there are two types of users that come across and use your system. One is your internal staff that we call as internal users, and one are your actual members or fundraisers who are the external users who are going to use it to pull in different reports and dashboards. So your staff before the implementation of AMS might be using a different system altogether for the different functions that they'd be working on. And this is a new AMS, new system for them. So it's very important to keep that communication going between you and your staff on how are they actually finding using the new system that has been handed over to them. Because if they face a lot of problems and they are not able to use the system well, with the passage of time, it will just be a matter of time that they would lose interest in the system and they would stop using it. So we need to define a proper user manual kind of stuff, or maybe proper guidelines for them, which are easy to understand and which actually helps them in smooth using of the system. Similarly with your external users, the members who are using it, because it's new for them as well. So you have to make sure that their user experience is good. They are able to get value out of the new AMS that you have implemented for them. And for that, you should take a continuous feedback from them and work on that feedback so that you are connected to both the users who are the actual users of the system and your AMS is in use and you are able to get the value out of the investment that you have invested heavily in implementing that AMS. Once you have got your AMS running, you would want to actually integrate that with the different apps. Now it can be a Salesforce that you want your AMS to integrate with. It can be a Cvent app that you want to integrate with. But let me tell you that any kind of integration that you are focusing on is not a cakewalk. You have to have a think about it before integrating any app with your new AMS, because as soon as you integrate the app, there is data flowing between the two systems. And you need to understand why you need to integrate that app. And for that, you need to have a champion team who can do that. So you need to identify the mavericks in your team who can actually understand the requirements, understand it from the different users on what they think about integrating that app, what value you will get out of integrating that app. So it's very important that you come up with a requirements document and an integration plan to do the app integration. So you need to identify the people who are actually going to do it. It's not that you ask any user to do the app integration with your AMS. And once you have integrated your app or you're using your AMS, data is one thing that is going to flow between your systems and your AMS as well. And when we talk about data, very soon you will realize that there is a lot of dirty data that gets accumulated in your system. And when I say dirty data, that means any kind of duplicate records, maybe your state abbreviations are not capitalized. And when your members are actually able to pull the reports, they are not getting the right amount of standard of data they are expecting in the reports. So data cleansing activity is one thing that you need to focus on. And that can only happen if you have a proper dedicated data handling team who takes care of all these things. Because you need to sync data with different apps that you have integrated. You need to cleanse that data at a certain frequency. Otherwise, a lot of dirty data will just get accumulated in your system. And at a point of time, it would be too much of waste to clean off. So it's important that you have different teams lined up, your app integration team, your data hygiene team, who are actually taking care of your AMS and helping your users to resolve your problems and troubleshoot it so that they have a smooth experience and they don't find problems in using the system. And to do that, it's important that you understand the organizational capacity to manage your AMS system, because you need resources for your data hygiene stuff, you need resources for your app integration stuff, then you need resources who are going to solve the problems of your internal users, external users. And so you may have your internal technical team or internal support team or internal admins who can do that job. But if you think you are running out of staff or there is a more need of staff, you need to get help from third-party consultants and vendors. And they can be able to help you out in doing all these kind of services for you. So you can hire app integration experts, a company who is good in doing the data cleansing or data management stuff, and get the ball rolling. Because once you have implemented your AMS, it's being used by users, there is no stop to it, and you have to make sure that you are ready for it, and so that you get the value that you anticipated when you thought of implementing the AMS. So I think that are the main key tips that I would tell you to take care of once your AMS is running. And in terms of Applicify, we are actually a consulting and managed services company who help a lot of our associations and nonprofits to keep their AMS working and running it smoothly. We help them make checklists, guidelines, requirements document, help them in supporting their data management stuff, data cleansing stuff when it is required, and maybe helping them in preparing their future roadmap for any kind of integration that we do. So if you have any more questions, or feel free to mail us at vcare@plusify.com or call us at 888-683-8281. I think that is what I wanted to tell you for this session now. I'll be having short sessions like this more often to guide you more on other AMS features and other AMS implementations. Thank you so much for listening. Thank you. Have a great day. Bye.